Hello TaleForgers, in this video we want to add to the project the equivalent of the well-known SignalBus from Zenject, that is MessagePipe. This package has full support for VContainer and features high performance. So let's dive in and see how to implement it. I'm on the MessagePipe integration page, I added link to this page in the description, so let's go to the message page official GitHub. As you can read in the documentation, we need to add core and VContainer packages, so let's copy and paste links in the package manager. The core package includes all the scripts needed to work and also standalone support if someone is not using VContainer. The second plugin is necessary for VContainer to operate properly. As we read further in the documentation, MessagePipe requires UniTask for its operation, so let's go to the package page. Let's scroll down to Get Started section and select Install via UPM package. Let's copy and paste GitHub URL to the package manager window in the Unity. Now let's go to the sample provided by MessagePipe developer. From the important things for us, in root lifetime scope we need to add builder.registerMessagePipe. This registration is necessary for MessagePipe to operate and should be done in the root lifetime scope, because it's our entry point for the application. I have explained in detail the implementation and operation of root lifetime scope in a previous video. I include the link in the description. In case someone doesn't want to configure root lifetime scope, you need to create a simple lifetime scope, which will be on your main scene and register message pipe. We don't want to use the diagnostic window, so let's skip this line for now. Further, as the tip states, if you are using Unity 2022.1 or later and VContainer 1.14.0 or later, you don't need to add register message broker. A set of types, including iSubscriber, iPublisher, or its asynchronous version, will be resolved automatically. That's it. We are able to successfully go through the MessagePipe installation process. Let's check out if everything is working as expected. To do this, let's go to the writer and create two mono behavior scripts. Message example subscriber and message example publisher. The big advantage of the VContainer relative to Zenject is that we don't have to declare signals, simply create class and send message. We need to prepare example message class with one public int example number, we'll send message from one object to another and read example number value. So let's go to the message example subscriber. Let's allocate memory for the iSubscriber example message, example message subscriber member variable, and also for the iDisposable, message by disposable. Then let's write inject private void construct with iSubscriber example message parameter. Inside method, we can assign variable. Let's prepare new method on example message with example message parameter, so we will be able to subscribe and unsubscribe from it. Next, write debug.log and print some message with our example number, because we want to know if our message is propagated, right? In the onEnable, we need to add subscribe. We can assign iDisposable variable directly, but I want to show you how to do it via disposable bug. So let's cache this disposable. Further, create disposable bug with parameter disposable. This way we can add multiply disposables and, in the onDisable, dispose them all in the single operation. In the next step, we want to implement MessageExamplePublisher. It is a simple class, just add iPublisherExampleMessage, ExampleMessagePublisher variable. Then let's create inject private void construct with iPublisher example message parameter, obviously assign our member variable. In the start method, let's write example message publisher.publish and create new example message with example number set to 100. This way our message will be published and our subscriber should receive this message. Okay, it's time to back to the Unity. As you can see, I have prepared simple scene with nothing fancy. First of all, let's create two empty game objects and attach to it message example subscriber and message example publisher respectively. Now we need to add lifetime scope. The default one is enough. So drag and drop our game objects to the auto-inject game objects and VContainer will resolve iSubscriber and iPublisher in the runtime. That's it, we can test it now. Hit play. And as you can see, we received the message with the example number value. Fantastic! I believe I have been able to guide you through the MessagePipe implementation process. Feel free to discuss if you have any questions or concerns. I would like to invite you to support us on the Patreon, where you can get the exclusive code, all models, materials or code used in this series, and access to early available content. Link in the description. Thank you for your time, I'm glad you are with us and our community is growing. See you soon in the next video.